Hello, Mother Funsters, and welcome to episode 4 of Bitrated with I'm Mellar, I should say, and I'm with Zendo. Mr. Zendo, say hello.
What's up? Welcome, friends. Episode 4?
Woo! Episode 4, yeah, and our guest today is Carrot _.
Hi!
Thanks for being here, Carrot. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
So,
I'm not hosting you still, so that's what I'm doing real quick. I'm not sure why.
So, tell me about your stream, Carrot.
Yeah, tell us everything Carrot.
Everything
Carrot
related.
I just kind of do whatever I want.
Really?
Okay. Which I know is kind of like one of those things, but a lot of Legend of Zelda for that reason. And that,
yes, we're all Zelda fans here.
It's like my favorite like game series besides like Animal Crossing, I'm gonna be like, I don't understand how Twitch streamers play Animal Crossing, because I play for like 20 minutes every single day. How do you stream for 20 minutes?
I have no
idea.
I'm
sure people play longer. They're not just going to tune for 20 minutes on Amazon.
But do they, like, farm for 6 hours? Like, farm catching fish? And, like, well, how do you...
I have
no idea. Yeah, I'd imagine it's just super chill and talk to their chat. Like, same for just chatting, same thing.
I mean, I have to say, I have seen Bob once stream for, I believe, 16 hours just mining in...
Minecraft?
No, what's that? RuneScape. Just mining.
RuneScape.
16 hours.
I have seen that. My older brother is one of those like hardcore OG RuneScape players, and I'm always like, he'll be like, it took me 2 full weeks, 5 hours a day to get to the next level. What an accomplishment. I'm like,
it was a good stream, man. You know.
What else do you stream?
I have been very much a, kind of whatever people have recommended me kind of streamer. It has been something that I've been trying to change out of, because you end up playing a lot of games that you really don't like.
Yeah,
that hasn't been great. And it's one of those things where, I have a hard time, like, once I've started something, just, like, dropping it and being like, okay, this wasn't for me. I should just move on to something else that I enjoy more so than sticking with this. So I have had a bit of a difficult time with that.
Thanks for the raid, Miku.
I do apologize. I forgot to turn those off. My bad. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for the raid. I do appreciate it. We are currently just talking to Carrot about her stream. So you say you were just talking about, you were doing games that you didn't really like because you were getting recommendations.
Yeah.
So were you finding you were getting more views because people were like, yeah, this is something she really wants to, that I really want her to play? Or was you getting less views because they could tell that you wasn't really into it?
It was kind of both. I was getting more, like, raids and, like, hosts and things for those games that I didn't like, but then once they came, because they realized I wasn't enjoying what I was playing, they would leave quicker. Like, here's an example, and please do not, like, kill me for saying I do not enjoy this game. Kingdom Hearts.
Everyone has their own opinions.
Kingdom Hearts! It was basically a game, to me, that just slapped Disney IPs in there. And if you had taken all the Disney characters out and just replaced them with other characters, you wouldn't have even realized it was a Disney game. And that rubbed me so raw. I was like, no! How could you do this to my, like... I'm a very avid Disney fan, so it very much, like, rubbed me the wrong way. And it just...
But that's interesting, because that's the part of the Kingdom Hearts games that most people, are like, adore, the Disney part. The worlds, and I agree, I like Kingdom Hearts too, but the bit about Kingdom Hearts, what people like are really confused about, is the confusing anime story, where some people are dead, some people are not dead, there's like a whole timeline, there's like 3 different timelines you have to follow. And like, that's the confusing bit, and they don't explain it, they just have random characters pop up in the middle of a Disney world, like from completely different like anime.
Yeah, it was really strange, because I've also never played any Final Fantasy games. So people were like, oh, that's Cloud, and oh, this is like whoever, and I'm like, I don't know who they are. I don't understand the hype around it. It was very much a game, I think, that was very popular for its time. And my boyfriend actually enjoyed the game. He told me it was mostly because he was a child, though. And I think that's what it is. I think it's like a nostalgia thing. Like the whole like friendship is forever like message didn't really hit me. It didn't like resonate, I guess. And the whole entire time I was screaming at Riku. I was like, I hate you so much. You are such a bad character. Like, get out of here.
She is always my favorite.
Like, she just made me, I couldn't handle it. It was one of those, like, I tried so hard and I did beat the game. But it was just a lot of things. There were a lot of things I was picking out. Like, okay, you go into, I can't remember his name right now, Pinocchio's whale, Monstro. You go into Monstro and the whole thing is the same texture, or like just put on the walls, the floor, everywhere, just over and over again. And I was like,
yeah,
just take out the whole level. if you're gonna redo, use the same texture the whole way, like,
yeah, I can see that.
It was just like, sure. It's one of those things when you're not enjoying yourself, you really pick up on those small little details that like really make you angry. And I felt myself doing that the whole way around.
Could you not turn that into a thing though, and like just point it out every time it happens? And
I was kind of mildly doing it, but that's because I'm a bit of a, I don't know if I'm allowed to say the A word on here, but
yeah, you can go ahead.
Go for it.
I wasn't sure. I was
the
like,
A word, the C word, the P word, the G word, all of the words.
Just not the N word.
I wasn't sure if you guys are family friendly, because I don't think I've ever heard you curse on stream, for me at least.
But he does. He swears like a sailor.
I'm not that bad.
It was just. Yeah, I don't know. It was just something that, and then even the whole thing, I feel like the whole part was like looking for Mickey, and then at the very fucking end of the game, you find Mickey, and I was like, I hate you.
Spoilers.
I wanted to buy. I'm sorry.
Wow, spoiler. 10-year-old game. Why don't you? Goddamn.
Yeah, but you, I was expecting to find him halfway through or something, like, and then like have him team up with you or like something. It was just really like. I had a rough time.
Is Kingdom Hearts the only game that you really didn't like, or are there other games that
you
just
never
like...
played the other ones, because Kingdom Hearts was one of them that I really didn't like. Wario World.
Oh, that's just a bit of fun, though. That's like a party game. Oh, that's...
No, not the Wario World, like the new ones. Oh, Wario Land. Sorry, my bad. Land. That game... You, like, expect to play it like a normal, like, Mario game. It is not a Mario game, like, at all.
It's a Wario like, game.
Yes. You go down these, like, little chutes, and you have to solve... So you have to find these chutes throughout the map before you get to the goal. The goal won't let you in if you don't solve a certain amount of these puzzles. And it was just... I like puzzles. I did not like those puzzles. I don't know what else to say about that. It was just, like... And then also, I hate the character Wario. Why did I decide to play a Wario game? Don't ask me. I hate Wario. He's my least favorite character in like all of the Smash games. I just think he's gross. And it was just... it was... the like there were four worlds, and each world had three levels. And then like there was a boss. The first boss that they have in the game is basically a giant... alligator wearing a hot pink bikini and a blonde wig.
This sounds like my kind of game.
Like, can you imagine me going in there? And I was just like,
are you sure that wasn't just Mellar in drag?
Yes. No, but I was just so confused. And I was like, and it was one of those things where I feel like the game didn't really, there was like no tutorial really. The first level kind of had a tutorial, but it didn't really like explain how to fight things.
Okay.
If that like makes sense.
Yeah.
And so I would just like, I don't know, I had a really hard time with that. I did complete the game, but it was one of those things where I completed it and I was like, it only took me 2-3 streams to beat it at like, I think I did it like 4 hours each time. And I was just like, yeah, I'm never playing this game again. My older brother has it, and he makes fun of me because he has it, like, on the original, like, cartridge and stuff. And he's like, I hate this game. But, yeah, no, that one was, oh, that was bad.
What was the game that you played on stream recently that you've enjoyed the most, then?
Give me a brief second to think about this. I'm trying to remember because I'm not good at, like, remembering things, I guess, like things that are just happened. Yeah. I'm a lot better with like, past things. And
ask me what I streamed last week to this day, and I'm like, jeez, oh, I don't know. I like, I just wouldn't be able to tell you. I feel deep.
I feel like I went through a period where I just kind of played like all the Zelda games almost in a row, except for like the handheld ones.
Oh, I appreciate
I did
that.
Play Minish Cap. I played Minish Cap. Minish Cap is, I don't know if I should say it's my favorite handheld. I'm not including Breath of the Wild in the handheld category, by the
way.
Like Minish Cap is one of those games that I have a personal like history with. When the game was coming out in America, people had already translated it on emulators, and my older brother beat the game 3 days before release in the US. And we had an emulator of it, and I played it all the time, and I used to like go to school and tell my friends like, oh, I already have Minish Cap, and you know, things like that. And I just have such a like resonance with the game for that reason. And also it's just peak my kind of game in that it's like a top-down Zelda. It's got the little puzzles that I love. It has all the characters I love from like even some of the console Zeldas, like it's got Malin, it's got, you know, it just has those characters and like it has a mechanic that really like meshes with me.
It's a great game, definitely. So what's your plan moving forward with your channel?
I'm streaming, yeah, because obviously Carrot's already she's stopped streaming recently, and I want to find out a little bit more about that. I'm interested because it seems like it was going well, obviously, with the games that you were enjoying streaming.
Yeah.
So, what's your plan? Like, how come you stopped streaming out of interest? Is it a personal reason?
Oh, okay. So the reason I stopped in, like, the initial reason is that I wasn't taking care of my IRL life. It was things like, okay, I have been unemployed. I wasn't sending out resumes. I was so focused on streaming that everything, like, it was like a horse with his blinders on. I was so tunnel visioned, and I wasn't thinking about my, you know, how this is for my boyfriend to work full-time and have to provide for the both of us. I wasn't thinking, and I was being very selfish. And also, it was one of those things where, like, I mean, I've, like, watched some of the changes that Twitch has been making, and some of those I really don't agree with. And just some of the changes are just things that I don't feel like, and some of the changes they aren't making, I don't feel like help smaller streamers in any sort of capacity. Dang. And I just, like, the search bar, I hate the Twitch search bar. I think it's absolutely awful.
I believe next month, they're adding a view changer, so like, you know, where it's like a filter on your search, so it's like so you can change by most views or by least views, which is really going to help smaller streamers, which is amazing. So I think that's going to be a game changer.
I did like the emotes, because I did get that extra emote slot for tier one, and I was really happy with that. And it was just one of those things where I kind of was like, hey, I need to take care of my IRL life. And if Twitch is making, I don't know, like good changes while I'm gone that I'm seeing and I'm enjoying, I will come back kind of deal. Mm-hmm. It's just been one of those like, I need to figure out my real life because I know I'm not going to be streaming on Twitch forever. Until I'm 99 years old, you know? Yeah. I'm not going to be... it also is always going to be a hobby/side gig for me. I don't think I'm ever going to go full-time. The only reason I would ever say that I have been kind of full-time is because I've been unemployed.
Yeah.
And, like, that kind of stuff. Well, like, I have,
automatically,
you know,
full-time.
Yeah. It's just things like, okay, I have a boyfriend that I've been dating for 4 years. We've wanted to get engaged. Do we have money for that?
Right.
Yeah.
You know? That kind of stuff, and we need to be able to save and be able to...
So do you feel like you've made a lot of steps towards that? Have you got, like, interviews lined up? Have you got a job now?
I do not have a job yet. It's been one of those things where I live, like, right next to a mall, and I've been going in every other week, like, handing out resumes and the whole thing, but it's been a pain in the butt. It's been one of those things where everybody expects, do you have 8 years of retail experience?
I've been there, honestly. Yeah. It starts to feel like
me too.
Banging your head against a brick wall, but all you need is one breakthrough and you're sorted. So
I was unemployed for a year too before. So
yeah, a year and a half here, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And even my boyfriend before, for a while I had been in, like, with a company for 3 years straight, and he was unemployed for a year and a half while I was working. And it wasn't too bad for me. But once he's gotten employed, at least, like, he has, like, a raise. He, like, he gets paid more than minimum, which minimum wage here is $8.25. I was thinking, $8.25 is the minimum wage here. Well, our living wage starts at $11. And he's making, like, $12.50 right now, which is pretty nice.
That's great. Yeah.
And, like, although... I'm just going to say he should be paid more because he, like, yeah, okay, he's, he does stuff for Apple.
Okay.
So he should be paid more because of all the training and qualifications he has to do all the time.
Yeah.
But it's just, it is one of those things where everybody here is... I've been, like, going out, and I'm trying so hard. We actually have a new company that just opened up here in town, and I'm probably going to go see them after this.
Wicked.
Because my sister-in-law bought some things that she has to pick up from them.
So you scratched on something quite interesting earlier, where you mentioned there were some things that Twitch are doing that you're not really keen on. Are you happy to share what they are?
It's a lot of that, like... small streamer stuff, although there is always, like, the you know, you see the headlines and things in live stream fails and things in, like, you see a lot of that where people the favoritism and a lot of how the people who actually do work at Twitch, it just depends on who you get, because there's a lot of things where even emotes, I've gone into people's you know, other people's streams, and I see their emotes and I'm like, how is this allowed on the platform?
Well, can you give an example? Like boob emotes, or...
I've seen, like, straight up, like, asses, like...
Really, yeah.
I've seen that, I'm not... This person doesn't really know me, but I have, like, talked to them, and they are very nice, but their whole thing is asses. Like, the whole thing, their overlays are asses, their emotes are different asses, like...
That's kind of funny. I kind of get that.
It's just one of those things where I'm kind of like, you know, but if you can't have, you know, an ass emote, or you can have an ass emote, why can't you have a drooling emote? Because, like, I have, you know, there's a lot of drool emotes have gotten, like, kicked out, and it's like...
It's hard to differentiate drool from the other.
Yeah.
I completely see what you're saying.
The gasm emotes, like, what about the gasm emotes?
Yeah.
Like,
no, I disagree with that. I disagree with the gasm emotes.
Like, I'm gonna say I dislike that one because I think it makes it Twitch too. It makes you think of Twitch as just, you know, just chatting. You know, where you see the borderline cam girls and people like that, and, like, I think it's one of those things where we need to. Twitch needs to pull itself away from that. Otherwise, it's always going to be seen as, like, a weird, risque kind of website that it is kind of right now.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard other people say they're not happy with the way that it seems to be one rule for one set of people and one rule for another set of people. It seems to be what you're sort of getting at there.
Would you consider going to, like, D Live or something else like that, a different platform. I know it's like the whole thing, whether you start again or your audience comes with you or whatever. Mm-hmm. But like, if you're really not happy with the way to which you're doing things, would you look to a different platform just to like continue streaming?
I would have to do more research. I really don't know and have a lot of research about those companies that are different. All I have really known is like, you know, what do I dislike about Twitch itself? I don't know a lot about the other streaming websites. So I can't really like put a proper, I guess, or no.
Fair enough. I think it's just about time. Sorry, go on, Zando.
Yeah, no, I was going to say, I think we touched on it earlier. Full-time streamer is our segment two, what we want to talk about. And we kind of touched on that earlier.
Yeah,
so I want to talk about when we, and we'll go like for each of us, when we think, if you even wanted to go that direction, whether you'd want to be a full-time streamer or not.
Sorry, just before, is we starting section two here? Because I just, before we did, can we introduce to your little bunny rabbits just before we go to section two?
So here's Timmy.
Yes,
Timmy. He's
able to get them.
Oh, I am going to say real quick. He's also part of the reason I stopped streaming for a while. When I was streaming, I got up, I heard a noise, and I went and I checked up on Timmy, and I picked him up, and he completely like fell apart basically in my arms during stream. And it turned out that he had gotten a very it's kind of like saying your rabbit has cancer.
Right.
Okay.
He got a brain parasite.
A disease. Yeah.
He had a very low chance of living, but he is here now. He is all healed. Everything is fine.
Hey.
I just had a really bad scare with him. So Timmy, he's an old man too, so it's kind of worrying. But you can see Artie's butt over here. Let me see.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Sure. There's
Artie.
Can
you grab one of them and just like?
Yeah. Let me see. I'm gonna leave Timmy because, you know, I don't want to bother him. He's in a good spot.
Fair enough.
But
Mrs. Zendo has a bunny rabbit tattoo. She has a tattoo on her hip of a bunny rabbit. She's obsessed with bunny rabbits. Guinea pigs as well, to some extent. But
he's gorgeous. The first rabbit I got.
What'd you say his name was, sorry?
Even though he's younger. Oh, I don't have my headphones on, so just give me a second so I can't hear what you're saying. But he's like 4 years old, and he's a Netherland dwarf, and so is Timmy. But yeah, he's pretty small. He's a sweet guy, and he poses for pictures.
Aww.
And also, if he can find a way to escape out of something, he does.
Yeah, he's trying to escape right now.
All right, are you ready?
Did you like that, Zendo?
I did. That's a nice little addition. We're bunny whore.
Actually, give me one second. I think I know what Timmy wants.
Okay. Timmy wants carrot.
Timmy wants carrot.
Do you like that?
Oh, look at his little bag.
Oh, that's so cute.
Those two rabbits have the run of the house. Look at that room.
Mrs. Zendo's happy.
Yeah, I've just got lots of
there
lots
of we go.
What did you say the second one's name was? The second bunny?
Artemis and Timmy.
That's amazing. All right,
Timmy I did not name. Timmy came from a different owner who his partner Dexter passed away, and so I got Timmy.
Awesome. I guess.
Yeah,
no, you've just scored me a bunch of brownie points with my wife, so that's great.
she's obsessed with bunnies.
Yeah, she's obsessed with bunnies. She has a bunny tattoo on her hip, like I've just won. Well, let's skip to section two. Like I say, we touched on this earlier. When is it okay if you want to go into full-time streaming, and we'll go around the room. I wanted to hear Carrot's take on it first. Full-time streaming.
Recently I've been watching another Twitch streamer named Bizzleberry. He does strictly League of Legends content. And I've been watching VODs, and he hasn't mentioned his full-time kind of situation, but he's at 13,000 subs right now. 1,300. I'm bad with numbers today.
That's okay.
So 1,300, And he has said that he just barely started making income off of that, like enough to be able to survive. Mm-hmm. So
for I think it's one of those things. Can I just lay it out there the way that a Twitch affiliate... So for those that don't know, I'll just do this really quickly. Every $100 you make on Twitch as a streamer, then you get cash out. That's kind of how it works. So you get money from subs, bits, and that's pretty much it, isn't it? Subs and bits are where you get money on that like number, that account, that balance. And then when that hits $100, then you get to cash out. Donations go straight to your PayPal. That doesn't account for that. Mm-hmm. Partners get paid ads, but Twitch affiliates don't.
Yeah, I don't know if he's partner, but it's just been one of those things that, like, if... I don't know. I would have to hit some crazy sub count. Like, he has, I feel, to really be able to do it because, you know, it's... Yeah, it's just... You really can't make much money on here. He actually said in one of his things was that he makes more money off of YouTube than he does Twitch. And mm-hmm. He doesn't really do much with YouTube. All he does is upload his stream. Like, really? No edits, okay. Nothing.
Really?
He just uploads it to YouTube and he makes more money on YouTube than he does actually, like, in Twitch.
That's interesting.
I mean, that's impressive.
And that's, like, including donations. That's, like, including, like, everything. And it's just, like... It might just be because, like, he has, like, two videos that are YouTube onlys, but it's only because he's talking about, like, the meta and, like, where he ranks each champ and stuff like that.
Crafting, essentially. Okay.
And it's something that he talks about during his streams anyways. It's just he kind of cut it out as, like, an easy-to-find resource.
Mrs. Sendo goes, so we need to be uploading videos to YouTube, people. That was definitely a dig at me and saying, make more YouTube content, Enzo.
Yeah, no, it's one of those things where I don't know, I don't think I would ever really make it full-time as well for the reasoning in that, for me personally, I like to think of myself as kind of an environmentalist. And my dream job right now is being, like, a park ranger.
Okay.
And I kind of want to be a park ranger, so I don't necessarily feel like I would stop my work towards that to just do Twitch. I feel like I would have to keep Twitch, like, part-time or as a hobby for that reasoning.
But if you had the opportunity, if someone literally said to you right now, like, I'm going to make, if you want me to... I will make you a full-time streamer right now. Would you take that opportunity?
My biggest question is, like, down the road, am I going to be able to find a job after that? Like, if after I'm done with Twitch, am I going to be able to... Does that count as experience towards anything? Will I have to go into something Twitch-related? Would I have to become a graphic designer? Would I have to become, like... Is there something for me after?
Right.
Is there job security? Like,
so the short answer for that is no.
I don't think I could.
I think content creator in and of itself is a qualification. You can make content on other platforms, and if you are well known enough and liked enough and, you know, subscribed enough, whatever, then other platforms are going to want a piece of that pie, and you could sell yourself to other platforms on that kind of note.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's also, like, how you spin it, because, like, you could say part of our job is a big social media management, and you could also go to a big company, like you mentioned Apple, like, it would be like, look, this is what I do this on the side, I manage these social media accounts in these ways, and post and tailor them in different ways because of different platforms, and you sell yourself that way as a social media engineer.
I've also seen some people that used to be content creators sort of retire into, like, how-to videos and that kind of thing on YouTube and make a lot of buck off of that as well.
Yeah.
You know,
it's just, I don't know. I don't know if that's something, like, I would want to retire to. I don't know if that like sounds weird. It's just one of those things where like I do really enjoy Twitch, but I enjoy it mostly for the creativity it gives me. Mm. It's not necessarily that the small individual things are things I would want to do as a job.
Mm.
And then like, and that might sound like really strange coming from somebody.
No, like, you know, no,
because I love.
Yeah, nature, and you love animals, and you've got that dream to become a park ranger. Whereas, like, for me, it's all about, like, obviously my family, blah, 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 but, like, career-wise, it's all about gaming. That's what I want to do. I want to be a Twitch streamer full-time. That's, like, the end goal, Jimmy. But, obviously, if people don't know this already, it's self-explanatory, but you need to be able to financially support your lifestyle with the income from Twitch, and that's not why. You get one good month of subs and you're like, well, that's it, kids. We're going to be a full-time streamer. It's got to be consistent. It's got to be maybe a year of consistent thing. And then I think a lot of money comes from sponsorships as well for like full-time streamers. It's not just that little balance that you get in every month. Sponsorships, brand deals, and stuff like that where you'll get extra income and it's not. Being a full-time streamer, that's like what we're calling it, but really it's selling your own brand. Like I've recently looked into a merch store, like it, and that's another avenue of revenue to come in. Like it's that whole thing, that final paycheck at the end of the month, not just from Twitch itself, that money coming in. Like I say, it needs to be financially stable, and that's the point when you can say, and like, what is going full-time? That's quitting your job. It's quitting your job to concentrate more time into Twitch, and it's concentrating more time in the day streams. But are you going to be pulling the same numbers and you doing your day streams for an evening stream? Probably not. Like, at least not straight away. Like, so you've really got to, even with the financial part, if that's completely sorted, you're already like a part of the channel and you're getting the money coming in to support yourself. You've still got to think, is it going to be financially viable? With no income from anywhere else, and for me to be doing this in the day, and then you've got to think, well, now I'm working from home, and then that's a whole other kettle of fish you got to think of. You got to think of the self-discipline that around that. Like you were saying earlier, you were saying like you wasn't really focusing on the IRL, you wasn't sending out the resumes, because you had to. I guess you lacked that self-discipline of a home work balance.
Yeah, it's definitely not something that I had, like, at all figured out, and it was just a lot of, it was just almost even one of those things where it becomes, like, hard to sleep at night, because my desk is in the same room as my bed, and so this became my workroom, and so it's really hard to sleep in your workroom. Mm-hmm. It's really hard to do a lot of those things and separate them and just like, and it's even one of those things, if you're going to be a content creator, you have to be on your social media 24/7.
That's my wife gets pissed off at me for that, because I'm always on my phone, we're watching TV, and I'm like retweeting my friend's dreams, and I'm lurking, and I'm like doing what you need to do, but she's like, well, you're never here, you're never really present with me, and then obviously pissed off, but like, this is part of the job, you know, you have to be, it's part of the networking to support your friends' streams, so they support you, want to support your streams, and then like it's part of looking up different ways to do emotes and talking to people. It's all that thing, and like I say, I'm constantly on my phone even while watching whatever show we're watching when we settle down for the night. That's, you know, it's a double-edged sword, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's one of those just like, and even like in, if you have a Discord, I had a Discord for a while, and it was one of those things where I was just like, I don't want to deal with this anymore. Like, get out of my face. Because it'd be one of those things where you're getting, even if I would, like, turn off, like, pings and stuff.
You still get pings, always,
Well, when people join a Discord that you own, they probably want to see the star of the show, which is you. They don't want to talk to anybody else. They want to talk to you. They don't want to talk to, you know, your mods, they don't want to talk to anybody. They want to talk just to you. And so you have to, like, figure out how to make it a community so that they'll talk to each other and they're not always just
That's
so
really good point.
Hard focused on you. And it's one of those things where even though I was a mature stream, I had a lot of younger people who would come in and, you know, do... You have to put your hard lines. If they're younger than your mature stream is, you know, 18 plus, if they're younger than 18, are you going to boot them? If they're younger than 13, which in the US is the federal law age that you can start being on the internet, are you going to boot them? Are you, what are you going to do?
That's such a hard question, right? Like,
and, yeah, my thing was if you're 13 or younger, or if you're not 13, I boot you. Just because it's federal law here in the US, and that was my, like, standpoint on it, but, like...
Okay, I can see that on your end, but in this country, in the UK, there's no, mm-hmm. or at least to my knowledge, there's no age requirement for the internet.
No.
Yeah. Yeah, so, like, it's a little bit harder for us because there's no actual law. It's just mm-hmm. on a moral standpoint, whether you should keep the kids in there.
Yeah.
When you say all the F's and C's, and you know, because you're playing the game, you're very excited.
I'd also say
if you've been to my stream, you know I swear like a sailor.
Yeah. No, I would also say it was a little bit ingrained in me though as well. Growing up from when I was 5 to when I was 18, I was a Girl Scout, and this might sound kind of weird. My mom like used to work for the Girl Scouts as well, so the boss favored me, and I used to get to do all the Girl Scout stuff. I was on the news one time, and I had to talk about cyber safety. And it's one of those things where you get it nailed into your head. If you're not 13, don't go on the internet kind of thing. And like that kind of stuff, I wasn't allowed to have any sort of accounts until I was 13. I really wasn't allowed to play any sort of online games until I was 13. And so it's like one of those, like, I see people who are letting their 9-year-old on the internet. And I'm like, what is wrong with you? Like, what are you doing? Because it was so ingrained in me that I see it as like a... You know, it's just like one of those, like, that's my norm. And so it's a bit weird, I guess. I don't know.
No, that's really cool. I understand that. Mellar, we didn't ask you, what's your take on full-time streamer, just real quick? Or did we kind of hit the points?
No, it's definitely an interesting question. I mean, I wouldn't say it's my main focus when I'm streaming, because I think if it was, I'd just go completely insane. You know what I mean? I always say I play for fun, which is definitely true. I mean, if I didn't play for fun, I probably wouldn't play the games that I do, because they don't exactly bring in, you know, all of the views and all this kind of thing. And I don't really play the whole socials game as much as maybe I could as well. But at the same time, like I said earlier, I mean, if someone turned around and goes, yeah, do you want to be a full-time streamer starting tomorrow? I'll be like, fuck yeah. You know,
me too. I would be like, all right, then I'll send him a notice.
You know, I mean, when I make decisions about the channel, I mainly think, obviously, is it going to be fun for me and the people that are watching? That's the main thing. But at the same time, I have this little thing in the back of my mind, is like, is this going to be helpful to me? And if it's going to be completely not helpful, I think to myself, is it going to be worth it? It is definitely something that's in my mind when I'm making decisions about the channel. And it is something that I kind of am roughly aiming towards. But I think the fact that there are so many people, I mean, you ask like 99% of small streamers, they also, I want to be a full-time streamer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's so many people that are going for it, and it's just not attainable for like 99% of those people. So like to for that to be like your sole goal while you're streaming, and then you're seeing these really low numbers while you're streaming, you're just going to end up looking at it and go, what's the point at the end of the day?
You need to have realistic expectations. Your expectations need to be realistic. I don't look at my view count while I'm streaming, that's what I'm saying. But I don't like look at my view count while I'm streaming and be like, ah, man, never going to get partner this way, you know? Like, I'm enjoying it. I'm like, oh, cool. This many people are here to see me. And like, you just got to manage your own expectations and do everything you can to obviously maximize your stream quality and put the time in. Do the research. That's what you got to do.
Yeah, there's a certain amount of expectations the people that are watching as well. Like, I won't mention his name, but I remember seeing a streamer, and like, he had the whole, you know, road to affiliate and all this on his stream title. And he got affiliate, And then as soon as he became affiliate, he changed it to Road to Partner. And then I'm seeing this guy, and he doesn't really interact with chat. He just sits there and plays Battle Royale games all day, every day. And I'm sitting there, he's sitting there with like zero views. It says like Road to Partner, and I'm like, you know, and that actually literally looks bad. But like, I think that's actually going to turn people off, because they're like, come on, mate, you know, and they're going to think, you know, that's a very unrealistic goal, and actually go elsewhere. So I think you've got to have realistic goals, but other people need to see that you've got realistic goals as well, I think.
Yeah, I saw, I don't know if you guys know about Gothic's model. She's a really popular streamer, and in the very beginning, she got all of her stuff for, Partner, but she applied for it, and she, like, didn't get it. After being, like, on the Twitch, like, main homepage, like, the whole deal.
Yeah.
Like, and eventually they gave it to her, but it was one of those things where even if you make all the qualifications, it doesn't mean you're going to be a partner, and I don't think enough people realize that. It's just...
Yeah.
That is a very good point. That is a very good
point. Is something I actually knew. But yeah, you have to... It's not like an affiliate where you hit the requirements. It's like, boom, affiliate. You have to apply, you have to send an application. They look at your branding, look at you, look at your social medias, and be like, is this someone we want to associate ourselves with as a brand? Because partner is essentially Twitch partnering with you. Partner is a word, but you've got to think what it means.
Now you're actually a partner of the company. You know.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it is. Mm. I think with that wrap section two. You want to go to section three?
But it's time to play sub, follow, or dip. Are you ready for the transition, guys?
We're doing that because on the first stream we... see, at this point, it's not even a meme now. On the first stream, we didn't have any transition in place for the scene change.
Here we go then. That does not look right. Hold on. Oh, I know. Hang on. What's going on? Oh, my bad. Okay. Well, we'll have to get rid of that, because otherwise we can't see you.
Yeah, I was like, what's going on there for a second?
Yeah.
Right. I'm going to change that between streams. My apologies, guys, but that's absolutely fine. Right. So we're on clip number one. It's Tasty Caring Goose Stinky Cheese. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we're all gonna watch it together. Are you ready to play the clip?
I have it open and paused.
Open and paused. Yeah.
All right. So it's the one that has party match at the top, right? And it says Uzi.
Yep. Okay.
As the title. Cool.
So in 3, 2, 1, play that clip.
Uzi. The room code is Uzi. Game.lol. Then enter the room code. It's Uzi. The room code is Uzi.
I'm not understanding why he's so excited about this.
The settings menu is pretty hip, Nebio. Have you checked it out yet?
That's what I was thinking.
Who's in my Uzi ooze? Vote for my answer. Yeah, I guess I learned a valuable lesson.
I feel like I kind of like the narrator for the game more than I like him.
Well, let's watch the second clip, shall we?
Yeah, second clip.
Same streamer, second clip. Clip number two. Let me know when you're ready. Yeah, okay, so 3, 2, 1, play that clip.
Oh. Really? Kinda spooky. What the heck, Nickelback? You typed in the same thing? But it turns out it was Plastic Spoon. I'm the only one who got it, okay.
If it was a spork, it would have killed him.
If it was a spork, it would have killed him.
I have no idea what this game is.
Wow. He's saying that I would have killed him. Dude. How dare. Of course, that would happen when I come home from work.
All right. Okay. So, Carrot, do you want to sub, follow, or dip?
I think I would dip, honestly.
Why is that?
I felt like he spent so much time on that first one, just like sitting there over nothing, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just kind of like, okay, can we move on now? Can you click the button and like we can move on and continue to play more of the game? And then the second one, it was like, oh, this is funny because Nickelback. Yeah.
All right. Like... Zendo, what do you reckon?
I honestly don't want to. I don't know. See, these clips are two pretty much of the same reason they clip. They're like inside jokey type things. Mm. That ooze was clearly an inside joke. Oh, the party room ooze? That's funny because ooze was the other thing. That was that clip. And then the second clip was his laugh was funnier than everything.
Yes.
So, yeah, I'm following him just for his laugh.
Really?
yeah. And then the second clip, I don't know if you got it because it was subtle. I don't know if you got it because it was subtle, but he was saying there was the question or whatever, and then it was saying, oh no, you'd be killed by a spork, but his Twitch name is Spork. So he'd be like, I wouldn't kill you. And then and that was the clip. That was why took me a second to get that.
At the end, he said, like, he'd stab you in the back or something, and
after
I was
work,
like, okay.
Yeah. yeah, that's why, because his name is Spork, and the announcer of the game was like, oh yeah, Spork killed him.
Alright, well, I think I'd probably dip on this one, to be honest. I really hated the first clip. It was more annoying than anything. I mean, even if it was an inside joke, he still laughed at that for far too long. And, like, it was clearly a fake laugh as well. I'm not really sure what that was about.
I don't know if it is. I hope it was real.
I don't know. It felt like a fake laugh to me. And then the second, like, in the second one, he kind of, he was clearly, like, interacting with his chat, which is nice. He's got quite a cool setup with, like, you can see the sound foam in the background and stuff. But at the same time, it's not going to hold my attention long enough, I think, to follow. It's a close thing, I think, but no, I think I'm going to dip on this one, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to move on.
To Uncle Vacuum.
Yes, I've got this. He's playing Zelda, so he already has my sub.
Exactly. 100%. Zelda or sub. Oh, okay. I know where this is.
Yeah, I think we all know where this is, but are you ready to play this
one?
Okay,
yeah.
Okay,
3, 2, 1,
play that clip.
That was awful. I kind of expected it to splat me up again.
Clearly a blind playthrough, because that happens every time.
Yeah.
All right, let's go on to so clip number 4.
All right. 1 second.
Okay, you ready, Carrot?
Yeah.
I'm ready.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, play that clip.
Oh no.
That's cold, man. Best day of the cow's life. Boom!
Did you see the comment on the bottom right hand side too? I was I was like, what in the world? I do not understand.
Can I just draw attention to the name of the clip? It's brutal, or should I say mootal?
He's definitely not. Sorry, Carrot, you go first.
Follow sub or dip.
I feel like I would follow, and the reasoning is, I will say he's got like his. He's improved his overlays, but his like actual lighting is worse in the second video than it was in the first one. I don't know what that was, but I feel like I will say he's kind of quiet and stuff, and it's more so about the game itself versus than him selling himself. But I feel like I would give it like a little while, and like after that, I might like dip.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. I don't know. It's if he can
it's
hold up to expectations. Yeah.
I'm getting the feeling it's probably a dip from you then. Probably.
Yeah. If he doesn't like improve and try to like interact with chat, I would just be like.
All right, Mr. Zendo.
Oh, he's definitely got my follow. So I want to say on the first clip, Zelda, loved it. His overlay on the first clip was nice. It was simple. The weird cam shape he had, it made him really stand out from the crowd. So, and he should have, I was hoping I'd see that on the second clip. I didn't. And then the second clip was hilarious. The overlay was overkill to the max, yet the face cam was still too small. So that's kind of off-putting, but the creative title on the clip as well.
Yeah, I like the title.
Is very,
it was not the streamer that did that. Effort.
Yeah, I was thinking, it's not always that's the streamer true. That makes right, the titles.
You're right.
Okay. So you're going to follow this guy, yeah?
But yeah, he's got my follow. I think he can be funny.
I don't know. This basically, I liked the first clip, actually, because it kind of is clearly a blind playthrough, because I think anyone who's played that before knows that happens basically every time. And his reaction to it was kind of cool. I liked that. I appreciated that.
It was a cool reaction.
Yeah. The second clip, though, I got the feeling that clip wasn't really funny because of him. It was a funny clip, but it was more happenstance.
Yeah.
And the fact that he sort of straight away moved on from it and just shot the cow. I mean, that in and of itself wasn't funny, but he wasn't trying to be funny at that particular moment.
Yeah.
And he had way too much silence in there as well.
Yes. Second clip.
Yeah.
For the second clip, especially, and before the thing happens in the first clip, there's no, hey, I'm going to go there and do this and that. And it's just,
yeah, there's far too much silence in there for me. I'm a dip.
Yeah. Yeah, he was just really quiet. And that was my biggest thing, too, was everything that was funny wasn't because of him. It was just the game being the game.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I'll give him a chance.
Oh. Okay.
Follow.
We're going to move on to clip number 5.
Oh, no, this username.
Okay. Are you ready, yeah?
Yep.
All right, 3, 2, 1, play that clip.
But she does this. Oh my god, Wraith, you literally like.
Oh my god. Why?
Oh my god, what? It's like she got bored of saying "aw," so she sped up. Oh my god, I don't know why I find that so funny. Oh. Compared with the fact that Wraith is being crazy.
Alright, so we'll go on to the second clip. Are you ready?
Give me 1 second. I'm ready.
Yep.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, play that clip.
If there were burglars in my house. Morph, I can't do it! If there were burglars in my house. First thing, I would grab them and be like, yeet!
What?
That's what I would be doing.
Right. Okay, Karen?
Interesting strategy.
I know, it was like...
Was that supposed to be a dab?
I think that was like a one-handed, like, I don't know.
Sorry, Karen.
She just messed it up.
Alright, so
I don't know. I feel like the first video, I was happy that at least like her like extended laughter was like genuine.
Mm.
Because like her face was getting red, you could tell that it was like genuine, which I did like. The second one, I feel like it's something that I would do and then I would cringe at later.
Right.
Yeah.
Which is very much me, so I do think I would follow. I think I would follow.
Yeah, fair enough. All right, Zendo?
Yeah, I agree. I follow. I clicked follow. She seems very down to earth. She seems cool. She's just chilling. Seems funny. And yeah, maybe a sub in the future. Who knows? She seems like a cool person.
What do you think of her overlay?
Not overly trying.
I feel like it was... I don't know. I feel like there's so much empty space on that right-hand side where there's just the cup. But I was like, what is the point of this? And like the first clip, there was nothing there. And I was like, okay, well then just take it off. But like, I did kind of like the little dog she had going on. I've never seen that before, but I don't know if like, I think that's for her like subs or something. I don't know if after a while though, that would, she would have to get rid of it if she like continued to grow. So.
Well, it's stream avatars, isn't it? I've got it. But I don't like those avatars. They're too big for a start, and there's too many of the same.
I thought they were too big.
Yeah, as well. Like, one of the things that I like about stream avatars is it gives the like your viewers an opportunity to be unique. But there's obviously not enough. There's obviously not enough avatars that she's downloaded. So there's lots of them that are all the same thing. The thing on the right, if I had to guess, it's probably to make it so that her cam is square, so that it's the right aspect ratio. I
guess so too.
But I don't like it at all. It's like you said, it's totally wasted space. I mean, it looks nice with the color scheme of everything else, but it could really do with having something else more useful there, maybe.
I even don't really like the image she used for it.
It's like the white colors. It's definitely the right
color. Yeah, it's nice colors. It's just, I feel like she could have used... it's just something different, I guess.
I like how minimalist the overlay is, though, like, just at the top left, because, like, if we but look back at the guy who played Zelda, that massive, chunky, like, overlay L-shape that everyone does, I hate.
Yeah, that space, though, she could utilize the thing on the right-hand side with that information instead. Maybe.
Even put in the, I think for her stream, if it was thin like that bar, a chat box would be good too.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Because it looks like there's a lot of viewers in there as well, like judging by stream avatars.
Yeah, but she seems to have quite good interaction with her chat. I normally don't go for like just chatting streams generally, but she's quite endearing. She seemed quite like natural and genuine with the way that she speaks, so yeah, she's got my follow.
I also saw in some of her clips she did have some gameplay, so I don't know if she's like 50-50s it, or like what her ratio of just chatting to gameplay is.
Carrot is cheating.
Yeah, you're cheating.
I'm sorry,
just by the clip.
Yeah, but, like, I have a monitor that's like, it's like lengthways. It's lengthways. I can see more.
We've gone back to the previous screen as well. That was a lot of fun, I feel.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I quite enjoyed all of that, especially segment 3. That was a lot of fun. Thank you for your input, Karen. Thank you very much for coming. How do you feel after the end of that?
I feel good.
Do you have fun?
Yes, I had fun. I wasn't sure what to expect when it came to clips. I was like, oh no, are they gonna like choose specific ones? Is it random? Are they gonna be like, hey, this one's the weirdest clip this guy on his entire channel has. We're gonna use this one. I wasn't like sure, so I was like, okay.
To be honest, the way that I mainly get them is I'll find a completely random streamer, and then I'll look for their top clip in the last 7 days and their top clip ever. And that's pretty much normally the clips that I choose. Sometimes if like one of the clips is really, really short or just rubbish, I might move down one, but that's pretty much how I find them. That's why they're so random, and they're not necessarily in order as well. So you were mentioning earlier about the second guy, how his overlay had changed. I genuinely don't know which is the one in the past and which is the one in the future. I have no idea.
Yeah.
So
yeah, good point.
I think the Ocarina of Time stuff was more recent, if I'm honest, but I genuinely have no idea.
He had like a weird black and white filter on that one, and I was like, I don't know how I feel about the filter.
I wasn't sure if that was the lighting or...
No, he definitely had a monochrome filter. He definitely had a monochrome filter turned on, for sure.
Okay, alright.
Yeah. I think that was a lot of fun. Just before we go, if anybody watching today or in the future on YouTube wants to suggest a segment two subject, then you can comment. You can speak up on chat now. You know, you can tweet us. Our socials are at the beginning and will come up at the end. Don't forget to follow myself, Carrot, and Zendo on Twitch, and like and subscribe on YouTube. Next week we've got a bit of a special going on. Next week we are going to be streaming on Gamer Talk's channel. Gamer Talk is actually in chat at the moment. If I can, oops. That's not how you do it. There you go. So go drop Gamer Talk a follow. Basically, the way that Gamer Talk works is they have a different streamer on pretty much each time they stream. So it's kind of an opportunity to, if you follow them, to see lots of different streamers. It's really exciting and interesting thing. I'm really looking forward to streaming on their channel. Our guest next week is going to be Virtue. The one on Virtue. Yes, Virtue. Which is super exciting as well.
Excited to have Virtue on.
Absolutely. It's going to be a special as well because we're doing an hour and a half rather than an hour, which I'm really, really looking forward to as well. So it's the same. It's actually the same day, Wednesday next week, except 6 o'clock in the evening rather than 8 o'clock because we don't have time zones to contend with Virtue because he's a Brit as well. But no, seriously, thank you so much for coming, Carrot. It's been an absolute pleasure having you. We've really enjoyed you having me.
Thank you. So,
we hope you return to Twitch soon and we would love to see you.
Yeah, I have some ideas, but I think my stream style would probably change quite a bit from random games to, like, I'm thinking, what is it? I really like mods and stuff like that, so I'm thinking of maybe doing, like, Breath of the Wild with, like, some small mods, not, like quality of life, not, like, we're gonna ride on Thomas the Tank Engine instead of a horse kind of thing, as well as, I think... I think I'm going to do Breath of the Wild and then, like, maybe... I don't know if I'm that much of a masochist, though. I was thinking of, like, playing, like, League or something, but I'm not, like, that good, so...
are we going to raid then, Zendo? Have you got a target, or are we going to just end it?
I'm actually in the process of trying to go live myself.
Ah,
because I'm going to be streaming. So raid me, that'll be fucking great.
All right. Well, let us know.
Give me a sec. For sure. I'm gonna go live. EA.
Hell yeah!
Sorry about the fucking terrible quality. We've got going on here. There you go. I'm live.
Hell yeah! Oh no!
Welcome, friends. What's good?
Alright, give us just a few seconds. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching. We will see you next time.